Explain the countercurrent extraction. The method was discovered by Craig and Post. It consists of 300 to 400 such chambers. The organic solvent and the aqueous solution is introduced to tube A and then it passes to B. It is shaken and is allowed to attain the equilibrium. Now the apparatus is tilted so that the upper layer gets decanted through C and is collected in D. When the apparatus is again made vertical, the liquid passes through D into E in next chamber of A and then to B. The process is repeated till the two liquids get almost separated. So let's talk about the applications. With the help of this method, we can have accurate quantitative analysis of a single as well as mixture of the components. In this case, apparatus required is very simple. For example, separating funnel, burette, pipette, conical flask, etc. Time required for analysis is very small. The method is very well used for detection of traces quantities of substances where precipitation method or gravimetric method is not suitable. Iron plus 3, ferric ion can be easily extracted by ether from 6 molar HCl solution of the ferrous alloy or iron ore. The method can also be used in the extraction of metal as metal chelates, where chelates has high solubility in immiscible solvent such as chloroform and benzene. In industrial or commercial field extraction by countercurrent extraction is frequently applied in the separation of components where the difference in the distribution coefficients are small. The phenomena is widely applied in drug analysis. The solvent extraction is used in clinical laboratory. Metal chelates are more soluble in non-polar solvents. Thus, nickel 2 in its tetra-coordinate complex with dimethyl glyoxime can be extracted into chloroform. In presence of citrate or tartrate, the precipitation of iron 3 and chromium 3 can be avoided. If you like this video, please click on the like button. And if you are new to my channel, please click on the subscribe button. And don't forget to press the bell icon to receive the latest updates.